Paradise, Louisiana, with Gary Risponi and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana would also like to thank these sponsors.
Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores, we have more than you expect. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, Farm Bureau Insurance, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, First South Farm Credit, Area Wholesale Tire Company, with tire programs for tire dealers.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana, and Don, the rodeos are still going on all over the state, and I don't know if we can keep up with all of them, but we're going to do our best.
Well, good thing the fishing has really turned on just in time for these rodeos, and you got to take part in a couple of really nice big ones, one that traditionally kicks off the rodeo season, the Grand Isle Speckled Trout Rodeo, but you also made a trip to Cocodrie for a very important one.
That was my first trip. It was down in Cocodrie to Houma. Oilman's Invitational, they call it, and Don, I just didn't realize how big it was. I knew it was a big deal every year. I've been to the Oilman's, the Bass Tournament, Toledo Bend, that's a big deal. But this is for charity, too, also, and the committee members, the board members, they just work tirelessly to do this, and they raised over $1 million already in how they do it. And I guess you say, well, the oil people got that money, but it's the workers that are there. You got to be 51% of them have to be in, and they do a tremendous job. And one person told me, say, you know, they call the Grand Isle a Big Daddy. Tarpon Rodeo, it is in age. But when you're talking about participation, there's over 3,000 tickets were sold.
Well, anytime you can have people out having fun catching fish and do some good for the community, it's a win-win situation. I got to make a trip over to Lake Ponchartrain this week. Fish with Captain Mike Gallo. We did pretty much the Cajun Slam. Lake Ponchartrain is starting to finally, after that long, cold winter and spring, clear up, and it's coming along rather nicely. Also, another tournament that got underway, the Star Tournament, the big statewide tournament and Angler's Rodeo put on by the Coastal Conservation Association. If you want to become a citizen scientist and do a little bit of that tagging like they do with those redfish, we'll show you how you can do that, too, coming up later on.
Good deal, and we got to, I was going to say a fishing report, and it's going to be a short one because we're going to be showing you a lot of fish that's being caught. By the way, when we went to the Oilman's, it was a little fishing was done. 3 days, we spent a lot of fishing. Some of us caught fish. Let's say that. Some people caught fish. Some of us didn't do that well. Some of us caught cold. But it was a fun trip, and all weekend. Let me tell you what. One thing about the Grand Isle Trout Rodeo, we were late getting there Saturday night, and we wanted to get the weigh-in Sunday. We walked in there, this band was rocking. And I tell you what, you know, I'm more of a Zydeco, old-fashioned swamp rock. This is a young band from Baton Rouge, and their name was Chase Tyler Band. Not only young people, the old people, they were jumping and jiving. I'm going to tell you what, it was a great young band, and you know, that's a party going on right now.
And the Louisiana State Master Speckled Trout Angler was declared too. We'll be back to tell you who that was as we travel the state, bringing you Paradise, Louisiana.
When you're ready to really enjoy life at a slower pace, become a landowner. First South Farm Credit specializes in financing and refinancing land, but not just for farmers. They offer loans to purchase timberland, hunting and fishing, or recreational property. Their experience in land, timber, and loans set them apart from standard lending institutions. Contact a First South Farm Credit loan officer for more information. First South Farm Credit, a specialized rural land investment lender helping you realize your dream.
Now in its fifth year, the Louisiana Saltwater Series Redfish Trail will visit 8 marinas across Louisiana in what is sure to be the most exciting season yet and a true test for the best redfish anglers. With nearly 3,000 redfish tagged and over $200,000 in prize money awarded, this is a 100% payout two-man team event for only a $200 entry fee. To register online or see when and where the next tournament is scheduled, visit lasaltwaterseries.com.
As members of a Touchstone Energy cooperative, we've all got a job to do. And the more we work together, the more we save. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy cooperative.
These engines run for thousands of hours to prove.
With 20% more cleaning agents than before, Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline.
No, the gasoline protects your engine better!
Awkward.
Try Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines.
No other gasoline protects your engine better.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and Gary got to make a trip with a good buddy of mine, and I guess if you were going to declare a fishing captain of the year, he'd certainly be in the running. Captain Mike Gallo, Angling Adventures of Louisiana, got the lodge over there on Salt Bayou, fishes a number of areas, Lake Bourne, Lake Ponchartrain, Lake Catherine, the Mr. Go, the Intercoastal, Biloxi Marsh, you name it, he travels around.
So many different techniques we have learned. I've learned watching you fishing with him on his show.
He's one of those, I guess you'd call him a theoretician. He has some theories on why fish do certain things. Another thing about Mike, too, is he keeps a lot of other fishing guides working. When he gets an overabundance of trips, he farms those out to some of the other guides in the area, and they all seem to work really well together in that area. We made a trip out to Ponchartrain. We fished the Trestle Bridge. We fished Highway 11 and also the reef that's located between Highway 11 and the I-10 bridge that was created from the destroyed bridge from Hurricane Katrina. With the efforts of CCA and some other folks, they created an artificial fishing reef. We found fish in every spot, and it was a mix of fish. There was some speckled trout. We caught sheep's head. We caught black puppy drum. We caught redfish and a flounder. And also some croakers that were pushing size that were keeping. Some of them were actually edible-sized fish. Fishing with a couple of methods. One, his famous drop shot, which is a simple bait. Sinker on the bottom, drop line coming off with a hook with a live shrimp, which, by the way, are available now at all the marinas around surrounding Lake Ponchartrain. And also with that Mojo mullet, Deadly Dudley's bait. Mike was the one that talked Dudley into going with that blue color. And Dudley was a little bit hesitant on it, but I'll tell you, Mike has a vested interest because he wants to prove that it works, and it has been working. Dudley attributes the success to that bait this year because the water's been exceptionally dingy. Even when it's clear of silt, there's a lot of water coming in from the Pearl River that has kept Lake Ponchartrain from being crystal clear. He thinks the fish see it a little bit better, and certainly held true. That was one of the baits that really worked for us.
Well, you tell you what, Mike Gallo is one you said probably up in the running for Captain of the Year.
Let's take it in now. He talks about this is kind of like fishing in April in May and explains why. Captain Mike Gallo, Angling Adventures of Louisiana on Lake Ponchartrain.
Nice and high. Real high, Jim. Real high.
Good trout.
Nice trout.
Right, now pull them up to you.
Yeah, now that is dinner.
Well, there's many different types of fish you can catch in Lake Ponchartrain, as we did today. Speckled trout, there's redfish, there's drum, sheephead, flounder, croakers, and of course the undesirables, catfish, gaff tops, stingrays. Stick and move, and you can put a good box of fish together.
Just making big circles.
Tuna?
Stingray?
Yellowfin?
Shark.
See the leader.
Dum-da-dum-dum.
I've been rigging my live shrimp on a drop shot rig. It's a very simple rig with your sinker on the bottom, and I use a small number 2 VMC hook. I like to hook my shrimp through the tail. We still were successful today with Dudley's new Mojo mullet, which worked very well on some of the speckled trout. You won't catch the undesirables with the artificials.
I'm gonna tell jokes all day if this keeps up.
You like that, Jim?
Speckled trout. And speckled trout, but not too big.
Drummer. Drummer boy. o'clock.
Oh, it's a flounder.
There you go.
Quite a dinner plate, but it's a flounder. So.
All right, there's a little speckled trout. What you got there, Mike? Here he comes. Ooh, a big sheephead. All right, if you're going to be fishing this weekend in Lake Ponchartrain, of course, the bridge structures are real popular, but don't forget about the reef. Look for these four buoys, and there's reef structure all under them that's holding fish.
Yeah, the reef is a bunch of crushed up rocks that are down on the bottom. Go over it with your depth finder to where you can find the depth and set yourself a slip cork right above the rocks. Get off to the side, anchor, cast up current, let your cork float on past, and then do a representation, cast up current, let it start across again.
That one's gonna go.
It seems it's fishing like late April. We caught fish in pretty much every spot we tried today. No real concentrations of fish like we normally see in May. So hopefully June turns out like May should be, and we'll have good fishing in June. So I'm hoping it just continues to get better.
He's barely hooked too. He's barely hooked. We're gonna take a chance.
Ask me about my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
When my daughter was 3, they found that she had a congenital heart defect. I can't even tell you if my child would even be alive today or not if we didn't have insurance. And it's not about just having insurance, it's having good insurance. If we wouldn't have had Blue Cross, there's no way we'd have been able to see what's wrong with our daughter. Because of my daughter's condition, I never know what day she's gonna wake up and not feel well. I feel safe with that card in my wallet because I can walk into an emergency room and they're gonna treat my daughter.
As sure as the sun rises over the Gulf waters, the excitement builds for the 20th year as the 2014 CCA Louisiana Star Fishing Tournament is upon us.
Me and some of my friends signed up last year, and believe it or not, I actually won.
Over 101 days of fishing with over 25 inshore and offshore divisions like the Youth Division, Speckled Trout Division, and don't forget the Tagged Redfish Division. We're the first to catch a tagged redfish wins a new Chevy Silverado. Register at ccastar.com. Share in the passion. Conserve our coast.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. And Gary, you made it down to one of the major rodeos in South Louisiana, the Oilman's Rodeo in Cocodrie. What were some of the highlights?
Well, the highlights to me is to realize there was 3,000 participants.
That's a lot.
That's tickets. Mm-hmm. You know, but I talked to Dan Davies and I talked to James Bergeron, the board members, and they had so many commitment members working there. But when you talk to these guys and you see that their love is for the charities, but this is a network, a way but all the people in the oil business to network. And not only is it a great business too, economically, but they make long-lasting friends. And that's what I came off with doing it. Not only that, it's a fishing tournament. Don't think them guys don't fish. They party at night and the food was outstanding. You know, every sponsor there, every company had a food. I'm gonna go on a limb and I'll say my favorite was the last night they had thin sliced ribeyes at one booth. And the bacon wrap shrimp, but they had a pastelaya that was real good. Now, you know I'm going to make the rounds. I didn't eat that much. I wasn't feeling too good, I'm going to tell you what. But all you had to drink and eat. But I guess the guy I got to thank more than anything is Chris Myers. Chris Myers, I met him a few years ago. I made hunts with him. And he invited me there. He hosted Gary and I. And he put us up, he paid our expenses, and he tried so hard to make it a great experience, and he did. Whether I caught fish or not, Chris, you were superb. By the way, all the monitors you see in that building were sponsored by Albedo Wellhead Services. He had 10 of his workers there setting all that up. And I think it's the first time that when they go to the weigh scale, they'd go to the monitors. As soon as they left the weigh scale, people could be up to date on what fish was being weighed in. So besides that, you know, Gary walked around there with his camera. I did. Let's just go and see what Chris can put together at the All-Mans Tournament. They call it the Houma All-Mans Invitational 2014.
Fishing in the sportsman's paradise with my buddy Keith and Gare. My first speck of the day. I'm gonna keep catching some because we're having this fish fry tonight, baby.
All right, Gary, you don't sound very Cajun. Where are you from? Why are you down here?
Tacoma, Washington. I'm down here fishing, 6 years down here fishing with my boys, and I keep coming back because I love it.
Hi, I'm Keith Webber. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana in Terrebonne Bay.
Up and he said, "You see that black cloud? It's following me." I said, "No, don't say that." So he said, as soon as we got to the land, it's the first thing he said, "You see that black cloud right there? It's following me." I said, "No way. It's all good." So we left in the boat and we took off and we got going and we headed across the lake. And it was a beautiful morning. I mean, the sun was coming up and you couldn't ask no better, you know? We got halfway across the lake and then we spun the bushing out in the prop. So then we was following Richard Hawthorne, which is one of the guys I work with, Bruce Beacon, which is his brother. And he's down there all the time, so he was kind of showing us some spots and we was going to follow him out to the island. And then he had to turn around and tow us back in, so it took about an hour, I guess a little over an hour and a half to get us back in. Said, "You know what, we don't want you to have a total messed up morning, so Mr. Gary, if you get in a boat with Richard them, and they're going to take you out and some fishing." So we actually loaded the boat back up on the trailer and headed back to the land and then moved to Houma to get another get our prop done. But they took Gary out there fishing and then they were surprised to see that the black cloud was following them when they got there, so it was kinda crazy. Yeah, when they got out there and they got to the island, they put the trolling motor down and they turned their trolling motor on. Well, they had a cell in the battery or something, and when they turned it on, the battery blew up in the boat. So his battery, so did they rectified that situation, put the trolling motor back up. They were just tripping and fishing. They was catching a few fish on top water. And then the morning was kind of past, you know, had passed away the best part of the fishing time, so they decided to come back in. And then when they run it back in, then they hit something with the boat. And they had to stop and check the prop or whatever. They hit it pretty hard, so they don't know where they hit some obstruction. So he looked at him and he says, "Man, you got to be kidding me." So whenever they got to the landing and they dropped him off, they said, "Don't you ever come in my boat again." It was pretty funny, though. But it was all in fun, you know. Well, like I said, we had a good time. And usually we catch fish, like, I mean, that's the time of the year where we go and we kind of fill up everybody's freezers, you know, with speckled trout. But it wasn't in the cards this time, you know. But it was still fun. We had a great time.
Welcome to the Oilman Fishing Invitational, the Houma's Oilman Fishing Invitational. Sure. With me is James Bergeron. James, thank you for the invitation to come here and do this. Wow. We've wanted to come here for so many years. This is the 21st annual.
Yes, sir. It began in 1994. The tournament began with about 500 participants. In those 20 years, we've generated for the community over $1.8 million. We have 32 food sponsors that start at 4 p.m. every afternoon and for 3 days, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And they cook from 4 to about 9. We give out door prizes every night. A total of over 700 door prizes. So you have a 1 in 4 chance of winning something. But our focus is to get the oil field people together. A lot of people haven't seen each other in a year, two, 3 years, and they see them here. We have people from Houston, Oklahoma, all over the damn place come to this tournament.
We have over 300 off-field service companies here, starting from the exploration, marine, drilling, production, and transmission of all gas and sectors. We've got the membership here, a lot of people here bringing their customers and their vendors, of course, and from that point, we do a lot of networking, get to meet and greet people that we hadn't seen in years, their customers and potential customers.
They come for the food and the door prizes. They love the door prizes. We give some of the best prizes away in any event. We got some of the most expensive prizes in any event that we give away, and they go for it. And then, of course, Dan comes up, and he's got his auction, and that's when it really gets wild.
Not
that long. You gotta try it, bro.
This is the kingfish per se. This is huge for us. And one thing we found is whenever someone gets involved with us over years, it seems to get bigger and bigger. And a prime example, I believe 3 years now, where each year we're just a little bit more here with the whole Houma Oilmans. You were there from day one, like you said it, and you're still around. So.
It started out, we just made some donations at first. Then we started, we actually got invited to go down to their tournament down there in Venice, and kind of grew from there, and we started doing more and more with them. And this year we had some of the warriors come down here, and the veterans, and we took them fishing and put them up in a camp, and we're having them a booth here so they can sell some tickets and do some show some people what all they do and what they're all about. And it's been a wonderful pleasure to help them in every way we can, and we want to do more and more as we go along. And people have been most gracious to help us with all the donations, and if we need anything, all we have to do is mention where it's going. And like we say, 100% of the money is going to the veterans, and people really blessed everybody with helping out. So they are looking forward to helping them.
Sir, my name is Doug DuPont. I hail from Lake Charles, Louisiana. I retired after 20 years of service to the United States Army as the 5th Aviation Battalion Command Sergeant Major right out of Fort Polk, Louisiana.
Yeah. Tell me your name and your rank.
Dustin Mintz. I was an E-5 Sergeant. I did 10 years in the Louisiana National Guard Infantry. I served in Iraq from 2004 to 2005.
Jonathan Purser. Was medically retired as a Staff Sergeant from the Army after helicopter crash in Afghanistan.
We have 6 wounded warrior veterans here, which we dearly appreciate their being part of this function. We provided them with 2 charter boats, guide service, everything they need to fish, to go out and enjoy the things. They sacrificed so many things for this country, and we only felt that it's a good showing for us to make them a part of our rodeo. Also, Crosby Towing Company cooked breakfast for them. So many people, amenities, for these guys that fought for our country. We're proud to have them here today.
It's a very humbling thing, and makes me proud to serve this great country, and it's the people like that that make me do it all over again.
It's a privilege to be around these guys. You know, they fought for our freedom, and I like to see them, meet them, hear their stories, and you know, you get to communicate with them, and it's nice to see them come out and have a good time and enjoy themselves.
Well, you know, sir, we're very proud to have served in the profession of arms. But there's truly nothing more rewarding than to return to your home and see great Americans enjoying what we take great pride in, and that's, you know, the freedom that is being an American, particularly here in Southwest Louisiana at the Houma Oilmans fishing tournament.
It's just very good for my heart to see that there's so many big-hearted, good people with the same type of values that I grew up with, and that there's people out there still supporting our soldiers and veterans that are currently serving or will be serving.
We have everything on our website, whfr.com. wounded warrior.com, Wounded War Hero Fishing Rodeo. It has everything on there. There's a sponsorship page. We do PayPal now. We have our tax ID number, which is beneficial for tax reasons. And the biggest thing that we offer is that every bit of our money goes to our veterans. No board members collect any money or anything like that. So it's a really good deal.
Congratulations. Thank you so much for letting me participate. And I think we're going to go look at the leaderboards right now and see what kind of fish have been coming in, because I promise you, it ain't come from the Black Cloud.
Travis Valentine.
Bob Danzer.
All states.
Catches Smecko. 29 pounds, 25 ounces.
Rob Cannon.
Avery Leroy.
Rodney Leroy.
Rick Kim Services. 4 trout, 20 pounds.
My name is Randy Hawthorne. I'm working with the Bredo. This is the first year that we've gone digital with our scales. All leaderboards will go on TVs, full digital. We're hoping to have internet access starting next year.
Hello, I'm John DeLabreton from Houma, Louisiana. We're out in Cocotree, Louisiana for the Houma Oilman's Invitational Fishing Rodeo, and you're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our 5 convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
How you doing? I'm Bruce Beacom with the Bredo out of Broussard, Louisiana.
Chris Myers with the Bredo out of Broussard, Louisiana.
Lou Schultz, Raging Cajun, from Bredo, Broussard, Louisiana.
Well, this is called the second day technique. After we opened the day of the Oilman, so we had a good rough day yesterday, so we kind of took it easy this morning. But the fish wasn't biting till midday yesterday anyway, so we thought we'd sleep in a little before we take off.
What's up, man?
You catching them?
That without diet or exercise, you lose 2 or 3 chances on your life.
Thank you.
to make the grease puff.
That is.
Huh? Hey, Lee Galan, I work for a Prado out of Midland, Texas. Here we go. The Houma Oilman Rodeo is the people that can that actually participate is all field related people. And everything in the Houma Oilman Rodeo, it goes to charity. So it's a very, very large event that is a charitable event, and it's a lot of people that participate. And I don't think the average person understands how many people is actually involved in this stuff.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
You watching Panas, Louisiana.
Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance doesn't hire celebrities to push auto coverage. We think people might like to make decisions based on service and savings, not just because that guy from that show says it's a good idea. Instead of faces you know from your TV, we offer faces you know from your neighborhood. Because we're based in Louisiana, with local agents right in your town. That's really the only thing we want to be famous for. Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service, real people.
Come to the family-owned and operated Cassius Casino in Port Allen today, where the Vegas-style video poker machines are ready for your entertainment. Cassius Casino is the finest, cleanest, classiest casino around. And Cassius 50-style diner is now serving seafood daily, along with your favorite home-cooked specials 24/7. Hey, Cassius is fun. Cassius is exciting. So come to the unsinkable Cassius Casino in Port Allen. Over the river, 2 miles west of exit 151.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. And while the Houma Oilman's tournament was partying hardy over in Cocodrie, down in Grand Isle, it was the Grand Isle Speckled Trout Rodeo at Bridgeside Marina, where the annual Master Speckled Trout Angler is declared. We want to congratulate Luke St. Pierre, this year's winner.
Well, we want to congratulate the whole St. Pierre family, because this is, I've had St. families dominate. You know, St. Sears have did it for years, and I'm going to call them the people from Looting, the Mighty Airs have did it with the girls and the women, the Bootsy Toops, and by the way, you know, Bootsy was down there, didn't fish too good, but every time I think of Bootsy, I think of Ulysses, his dad. Boy, you talking about an empty spot at that rodeo, because he was always over there listening to the music, drinking his cold beer, and fishing with him. But, Don, it's all about the St. Pierre family. And it was unbelievable what they did. They fished it for years. They've been close. They've been on the board. But let's explain a little bit how this works. There's 3 days of fishing. To be the master angler, you really need to weigh a trout in the top 10 all 3 days, because it's the accumulation of the weight or the total weight for those 3 days is the master angler. They also got the big fish winner in the ladies division. And by the way, a ladies, well, what about the accumulative weight of the master angler? Yeah, the master angler's been a lady before. Well, you call it the mistress angler. Master angler or mistress angler, whatever it was, it's been a lady winning it before. So, but the St. Pierre's, the daddy was on the board all 3 days. Luke was on the board all 3 days. And his son took first and second in the children's division. By the way, congratulations to Miss Mary Jackson. And fishing with her husband, Bobby, former guide. They all caught fish. Here we go. Grand Isle Trout Rodeo 2014.
Hi, I'm Bob Savan, president of Speckled Trout Rodeo. Summer has officially started 2014 here in Grand Isle, Memorial Day weekend, and we are going to have a great time.
You, Speckled Trout?
Three.
You made a super job of catching a fish, girl. A little champion right here. Everybody give her a hand. Here.
Yeah, this tournament's so hard to win because all the great fishermen and, you know, the Mitchells and Charlie Lears, I mean, that's just tough guys to beat, and this made it special. Our pattern this weekend was you had to have live bait. We were free-lining croakers in the Fouchon area, and caught some, you know, on a Carolina rig too, and we just had it going on. We found a good school of fish, and we stayed on them for 2 days. John Luke was, he was netting. He netted the two big fish on top of catching his children division fish, so he had a big day too. It was a total team effort, and, you know, I just very excited.
On the beach at Fouchon.
Yeah, and what was the bait? Tell us a little croaker. Bit about it.
I used a croaker. And we pulled in about 50 fish, but finally caught a big one.
Jean-Luc St. Pierre, children's champion, not only first, but second also. Jean-Luc, tell me how old you are and where you go to school.
I am 8 years old, and I go to Fatima.
Fatima School in Lafayette?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the pattern y'all use to catch all them fish? St. Pierre family wiped the board this week. Tell me what pattern y'all were using. When by pattern, I mean what bait and what area?
We're using croakers, and we were at the beach.
You're on the beach, huh? What did it feel like when that big one hit that croaker? You let him run?
I let him run, and I tried to reel as hard as I can.
Yeah. Is this the first time you ever placed in a children's division at this rodeo?
This is actually my second time.
You're amazing. Boy, the St. Pierre have been fishing a long time. Congratulations. Mr. Wayne, you have got to be some proud.
I've got a big smile on my face. These young men, my son, my grandson, they've worked hard for where they are. You know, we've learned from a lot of great people here on Grand Isle. Buggy here at the marina has helped us out tremendously. It's just rewarding. It's fulfilling. And I just couldn't be happier.
Yeah, three generations it was going. You got something else you want to say?
Yeah, I wanted to really thank Buggy and Doty. You know, they're just really great people, and the marina's first class here. So anybody coming to Grand Isle, y'all need to stop here. It's the best marina on the island.
Especially those Bridgeside Dynamite. They brought in a lot of winners this night. This is it from Grand Isle, Louisiana. I hear Daddy want to say one more thing. Let me go back before I go.
Well, I'm very proud to be here with my son and my grandson. And
three generations
long, and we watch Paradise, Louisiana all the time. It's a fantastic show, and we appreciate you guys being here to do this and promote it.
I didn't have to prompt that, but thank you very much. This is Paradise, Louisiana. Thanks to Gary Krause, who does all the work. Just remember, keep posted on Paradise, Louisiana, because we got a lot of tournaments coming up from Grand Isle all the way to Venice. So stay tuned.
We build tires, but not tires like anybody else. We build Cooper tires for people, not just cars. People who are chauffeurs and shuttle pilots, heavy haulers and heavy hitters. More than what your Cooper tires can do, it's about what you can do with your Cooper tires. Life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
I never forget the look on my doctor's face. He said, you have prostate cancer. The operation was 14 months ago, and I'm here now to say I'm cancer-free. I got the best of both worlds here. I got a doctor who took my cancer away. I got Blue Cross who took the bills away. Remember the decision that I did 19 years ago, the best decision of my life.
Why don't you make the best decision of your life for you and your family and sign up for Blue Cross?
When you're ready to really enjoy life at a slower pace, become a landowner. First South Farm Credit specializes in financing and refinancing land, but not just for farmers. They offer loans to purchase timberland, hunting and fishing, or recreational property. Their experience in land, timber, and loans set them apart from standard lending institutions. Contact a First South Farm Credit loan officer for more information. First South Farm Credit, a specialized rural land investment lender helping you realize your dream.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. And Gary, you know everybody's excited because the star tagged redfish have been turned loose. First one caught wins a Chevy pickup truck and boat motors and trailers for the next nine. But if you want to become what's called a citizen scientist and participate in some of the data that's being gathered about tagging redfish and other species, our Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries has a program that's absolutely free and will get you started in that. I got an opportunity to fish down in Grand Isle with Daryl Carpenter, and one day we decided we were going to do some redfish tagging. We fished in some of the back ponds, catching eligible size redfish, those under the 27-inch size, putting tags in them, notating where they were caught, the size, where they were caught, and other information that you put on there. And of course, if you recapture a fish with a tag in it, there's usually a number on there for you to contact. They'll give you the history of that fish, where it was originally caught, and a little bit of the background on it. So it makes it kind of interesting and fun, and really gives you a sense of pride that you're participating in some research.
Is there a difference in color with the star in terms of, because I know if I catch a fish with a tag in it, I've caught one in my whole life, and it had to do from wildlife fisheries. It wasn't a star in my heart then. I got a little excited there for a while, but it was another fish. Is it different colors?
Yeah, well, you got red for the star. The ones that you're doing for wildlife and fisheries, yeah. Those are little yellow tags.
Yeah. Okay.
And if you want the details on it, go to the website or give them a call, and they'll get you set up on it. We're going to take you down there now and go through some of the procedures, show you how it's done if you want to become the latest of Louisiana's citizen scientists.
All right, there's a nice little red, too small to keep. Let's mark him so we can track him.
Okay. All right, you pick a scale, single scale. Load the tag. Oh, what am I doing here? Load the tag. Yeah. I need a measurement. Stick him on the ruler down up front and measure him.
13 1/4.
They try to encourage what they call citizen scientists. It's so that they can track the fish where it's caught. Whenever we tag a fish today, that tag is then entered in the computer, and that tag sits there in the computer until that fish is recaught. When someone catches that fish with that tag, they call it in, they get a reward, t-shirt, baseball cap, plaque, that kind of thing. And then you get the neat thing is, me as a tagger, I get a report telling me how much that fish has grown and where it was recaptured at. It's a way for them to keep track of the movement and in the growth rates.
Take me.
Huh?
Go back here for the front. So you got some fight? Yeah, he even got a few flips in him.
Oh yeah, he was holding the cork under. Yeah, he makes 16. Let's get it right there.
There we go.
That's where it is.
All right.
16 1/4.
So this one was, what number was the last one you got? This was 789.
Okay, this was
He looks like he's about 14 1/4.
Yeah.
this out of it. We're going to net this one, Brian. He needs a net around him. Yeah. ½. Good to go. He's gone. There we go. That's a red. Good red. Good red. Need net, we are. All right. So if you want to become a fish tagger, just go to the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries website and you'll find out all the details. We got another one to tag and release. Not gonna make the chickens and the cows happy, but he'll be happy.
We build tires, but not tires like anybody else. We build Cooper tires for people, not just cars. People who are chauffeurs and shuttle pilots, heavy haulers and heavy hitters. More than what your Cooper tires can do, it's about what you can do with your Cooper tires. Life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
These engines run for thousands of hours to prove.
With 20% more cleaning agents than before, Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline.
Oh, the gasoline protects your engine better!
Awkward.
Try Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines.
No other gasoline protects your engine better.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
As sure as the sun rises over the Gulf waters, the excitement builds for the 20th year as the 2014 CCA Louisiana Star Fishing Tournament is upon us.
This tournament's for everyone. My daughter and I look forward to it every year.
How many can be caught over 101 days of fishing? And there is something else at stake. Your share of over $500,000 in prizes.
I plan to catch the first tag redfish this year and win the new Chevy truck.
Register at ccastar.com. Share in the passion. Conserve our coast.
Come to the family-owned and operated Cassius Casino in Port Allen today, where the Vegas-style video poker machines are ready for your entertainment. Cassius Casino is the finest, cleanest, classiest casino around. And Cassius 50-style diner is now serving seafood daily, along with your favorite home-cooked specials 24/7. Hey, Cassius is fun. Cassius is exciting. So come to the unsinkable Cassius Casino in Port Allen. Over the river, 2 miles west of exit 151.
Welcome to the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report, and Gary starting offshore. I had a couple of nice offshore species came into that rodeo you covered down in Cocodrilla, 111-pound yellowfin tuna. Also a new, what is a potential new seventh place, Louisiana Outdoor Writers Association state record Almaco Jack.
We're fishing out at Ship Show 332 on Friday of this week and dropped a live hardtail out of 332 and ended up catching this Almaco Jack, and the captain on the boat said it was the biggest one that he had ever seen before, and definitely the biggest one he had ever put on his boat, and thought it would make the state record list. So we came down here to the Cocodrilla Marina and got everything dialed in, and it took number 7 on the scoreboard.
By the way, it's a good time to mention, if you suspect that you may have caught an official state record fish, Louisiana Outdoor Writers Association, go to the website. The form is there and all the instructions how to get that fish claimed. It was 36.15 pounds. Joe Newmanham caught it, and Almaco Jack should make the new records.
Well, while you mentioned the LOWA, also the Children Writer and the Photographer Contest are coming in. And Don, you've been part of that for years and years. Can you explain a little bit more about it and how you can participate?
There's a couple of categories.
You've got to go through the advocate, right?
Well, you can go to Louisiana Outdoor Writers Association. Also, the advocate paper is also will get you there. But they'll give you the rules and the details on how to enter, written a story, an essay on something, an outdoors experience. Also, there's a photography competition, which is open for all ages, two classifications on the written essay. You got till July 22nd, so help your kids out. Get them started in becoming what we do, outdoor writers. Getting back to the fishing report, saltwater fishing. Speckled trout are coming in all along the coast now. You saw that at the two rodeos you went in. People are saying that the fish have finally showed up. The shrimp are available. By the way, recreational trawling season is open in Zone 2 and will open on June 2nd for people that want to get out and do some recreational shrimp trawling.
Why are you talking about seasons? Guess what else opens up on June 1st?
Frog.
Frogging, that's right. Them big old frog legs. And by the way, they had a bunch of frog legs at the tent the other night. But listen, Don, you're talking about kokodrilla. This is amazing me. Gary Krause and all those people there. I don't fish it enough, but I've fished it through the years. But we covered a lot of it. And we've seen people who were catching them on the beach. They were catching them in Lake Barray. They were catching them in Pelto. They were catching them at Caillou Lake. Caillou Island, excuse me. The rigs around there. You know what that one's one of the hottest baits were? You know, and when you've seen that fishing trip, you've seen Gary was fishing with the Webbers. They were fishing sparkle beetles, double sparkle beetles, chartreuse on top, you know, and white on the bottom, and they were catching. I talked to two or three people, asked them where they were catching, and fishing on the beach, fishing on the bottom using sparkle beetles, the old split-tail sparkle beetles. So if there ain't a better fishing report than that, that's artificial. Most of the big trout out people I talked to were fishing shrimp or topwater. You know, in that area, also best in Grand Isle. When we got to Grand Isle, you know, you've seen where they caught those trout during the Grand Isle Rodeo. They went west. One big stringer came from Venice and ran all the way to Cocodrilla, the top five stringer. So that's what I'm hearing. But you've seen they had some fish coming in. We're talking about tuna. Amberjack have really been coming in. A lot of people offshore. It was beautiful weather. It was a little choppy some days, but it was beautiful.
Looked like the lemon fish was filled up, too, on the
board. Oh, yeah, that's right. On the board, there people, a lot of people coming in with lemon fish. It's getting ready to open wide open, and a good thing it is because we got a lot of tournaments. And talking about tournaments, you know, had a great turnout to tag in the American Rodeo. Robbie, I'm sorry I didn't have time to mention all of them, but we'll run them on the board. But thank you for the pictures, Robbie. Italian American mm-hmm. Rodeo had one of the biggest crowds ever. And thank you for keeping us abreast.
And we've got a lot of rodeos coming up, which you'll see on the screen. Freshwater, you got to say, brim fishing is reaching its peak right now. Maybe at its peak. I'm getting good reports. People catching them on the Gulf crickets, live crickets, worms, and even on some of the little micro jigs in a lot of the areas. And probably one of the best spots is down there in the basin right now.
Well, I'm hearing some stuff from the basin area, but most of us come from by a black area in the Lake Verret area. My grandson and Emma went in the Lake Verret area, and then you saw the report from Meepaw that he was catching those. He's catching a lot of catfish all over. Everybody's catching those catfish in a brim. People have got it, and if you know Lake Verret, and you got to watch that because if it gets windy, it can get rough. You get trapped on the wrong side. But they're catching fish on crickets and they're catfish on worms. They're fishing the Michelle Canal, you know, on one side of the lake, Crackerhead on the other side. You fishing them canals off of that or fish the points in the lake itself.
Yeah. All right, North Louisiana, what you hearing from up that way? Run still going on at Toledo Bend?
You know, no, Don, I didn't hear nothing because I've been the last 8 days or the last two weekends in Grand Isle or Cocodrilla, and I don't do it. But, you know, I want to go back to the tournaments. The locals won that IFA, the Redfish tournament.
Right.
We got Jason LeBlanc and Corey Mathern won. And also the kayak division, guess what? Steve Lassard is over there again. And I'm going to chastise these guys. You know, the thing I'm patronizing Joe. I'm getting this stuff off the paper. If y'all want more coverage, please send it to me in an email and give me more information so I don't have to steal stuff from Joe Macaluso.
I wouldn't exactly call it thievery. But anyway, send your pictures, your photographs, and your stories too to us at Gary@Paradise, Louisiana. We'd love to get it on for you. And I tell you what, you're getting ready to go do a garfishing trip. And speaking of garfish, we're going to go out on some garfish that Deadly Dudley Vanderborn has gotten to know up close and personal. We call it Deadly Dudley's Aquarium.
What happens here, because you throw the fish carcasses back in the water, the garfish have come here, they know they get that easy meal. They've been coming in for a long time. They're sort of like pets. You could see them real clear, pick them in the waters like it is right now. But they've been coming in for 10, 15 years, and it seems like more and more.
Well, the gars have been here a long time, but you kind of got a new addition down there with those drum. When did they show up?
The drum showed up this year. And, you throw a piece of crab down that way, and they'll grab it, and they'll actually pull it out of the mouth of a garfish.
Maybe it's the reptilian scales or razor-sharp teeth and that intimidating prehistoric look that give garfish its undeserved bad reputation.
We used to indiscriminately kill them. I feel bad about that now because they're really a gentle fish. They're not the fish people make them out to be.
Now, the price at Dudley's Aquarium is free. The only rule is no hooks allowed.
Paradise, Louisiana, with Gary Risponi and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana would also like to thank these sponsors.
Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores, we have more than you expect. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, Farm Bureau Insurance, Louisiana Fish Fry Product, Demco, First South Farm Credit, Area Wholesale Tire Company, Tire Programs for Tire Dealers.